While addressing leaders of cooperatives from the Rwenzori region, the Minister of Cooperatives, Fred Mugume Ngobi, revealed that government is planning to revive the cooperative bank. Ngobi urged all cooperators to support the institution when it finally becomes a reality.
There are many banks here. We have DFC, we have Sentinel, we have Orient, we have Absa. But in these banks, maybe Sentinel has some local belonging. But these banks are foreign owned. Why would you get a society, a cooperative staff, with 2 billion to bank with Orient, the parliamentary staff, Wazalendo? We bank with foreign banks. And then they continue, even PBM cash is in foreign bank. And they need to make profits.
In January this year, the Bank of Uganda was tasked to explain how it seized and sold off assets of Cooperative Bank of Uganda without liquidating the institution. According to records available, the Cooperative Bank was registered in 1964 under the Cooperatives Act and has never been liquidated or abolished. Following the turbulent economic and political times, its operatives were disrupted and it virtually collapsed with the collapse of the cooperative movement as privatization and economic liberalization took root. Ngobi says the bank will enable Ugandans to enjoy smooth banking since it will be locally owned.
It's very powerful. And I'm excited that the government has given us an opportunity to cooperate. Did you ever know that a football club like Barcelona belongs to the cooperative? Are you aware? Barcelona football club belongs to the cooperative. The Uganda cooperative movement has grown.
Minister Ngobi urged transparency among cooperators and to always stick to planned activities to ensure unity and progress.
Not deliver. I don't understand them. Because we have prayed, Honorable Minister, we have prayed the way our Uganda has prayed, including producing prophets and so many all sorts of God-related messengers. People are still poor. So then what are we praying about? Is this the best approach? I think we have a wrong connection with God.
The regional cooperators also jointly issued a statement to the government that includes issues they want to see government work on. Among them include continued creation of enabling environment for cooperatives to thrive by strengthening the policy and legal environment. The cooperatives also want the government to decentralize government services that are critical for growth of the cooperatives.
Borrowing from some other interventions, there are models that we may not have enough staff, and where we are going, the population is increasing, we may continue having that problem. So in order to mitigate it, I want to advocate that we can have people trained, like agent, like village agents or chain agents, or we can now call them cooperative agents.
And you know our people, who are struggling to get the payrolls, you have to be facilitated. Because the small grant we have, as far as trade is concerned, is very small. And the luggage we have.
Report compiled by Junior Dusungwire for the news.